to the platform, I'd like to provide you a little bit of background information. Joe Peterson was born on June 18th, 1988 in Austin, Texas. He grew up with a great family, a stay-at-home mom, and an Army father. He loved school, he was a football star on his high school team, and he fell in love with his high school sweetheart, Judy, and they got married at the bright age of 18. Joe decided to join the Army and follow the footsteps of his father when he was 20 years old and became a medic. Whilst he was on a trip overseas, he got news that his wife, Judy, was diagnosed with a brain tumor. Although this news was devastating, the couple was also found out they were expecting their first child. Unfortunately, Joe's wife passed shortly after giving birth to a beautiful baby girl, Elizabeth. Joe and his daughter relocated to Danbury, Connecticut, where he decided to start a new life for the two of them. He attended Naugatuck Valley Community College and gained his associates before transferring to Western Connecticut State University for his bachelor's degree in nursing. Now he works for Danbury Hospital as a registered nurse as he works towards a medical degree to become a brain surgeon. Joe fell in love with the town of Danbury when he moved here and found himself surrounded by an uplifting and bright community. Now, Joe wishes to run for your mayor to give back to the town that has given him so much.
Okay, I think I see some students out there. Students of WestCon, I'd like to take a moment to discuss an issue that I'm sure is on your mind, the WestCon plague. It's no secret that the mismanagement of WestCon facilities and lack of informed judgment dealing with the norovirus outbreak have taken a toll on your community in these past few weeks. You need a leader to step in and take measures to ensure you won't ever have to deal with a health crisis in the 11th hour again. You need a leader with relevant medical experience, connections in the fields of epidemiology and public health, and a vested interest in prioritizing your health and safety. That leader is Joe Peterson. If elected, Joe will work closely with WestCon and other state schools to make your environment healthier than ever and make sure your concerns are always heard.
Hi everyone. When considering candidates for the mayor of your city or town, the person that is going to keep everything together and moving forward in Danbury, you want to know how they're ever going to connect with everyone on a more personal level. Joe Peterson is the person that will do that. With his experience in the nursing field and being a single father to his daughter, he knows how to put himself in other people's shoes and understands the wants and needs of families. He's no stranger to the hardships of family struggles, and as a nurse, he's seen just about all there is to see when it comes to the health, well-being, and safety of the Danbury natives. Even though he grew up in Texas, Joe has accumulated wealth to the Western Connecticut area and has immersed himself in the culture and activities that we have to offer. Joe Peterson is the candidate you want because of his determination to keep Danbury a safe place for everyone that lives here or even just passing through. This city welcomed him, and he wants to keep Danbury a safe place that continues to welcome newcomers just like he was, with smiling faces. This safety includes the health and well-being of all inhabitants, creating a better school system with a better budget, and especially to help families that may be struggling, as well as making sure they are in a good and prosperous city to raise their children in. I will now let Tashika provide a short intro to Mr. Peterson's speech. Thank you.
Thank you, Lauren. Today, as a community, I would like to introduce a great person of courage, a person of great resilience, a person who wants to change in our community. This person has served in the United States Army as a medic for many years. This person has dedicated countless times volunteering at homeless shelters and coordinating fundraisers for retirement home. This person is able to do what society says he can't do. This person is resilient beyond all measures. He is able to save lives in a Danbury hospital while being a tremendous role model and a father to his daughter. This person invested a great deal into our community. This person wants to improve our health and safety in the Western Connecticut State University. This person wants to be a voice to be able to intervene into our school systems and be a voice to, excuse me, This person wants to intervene into our schools, better our children's education, and be a voice on where our budget goes and where it's being distributed. This person wants to make Danbury a better place for us to raise our children. This person is passionate about the well-being of Danbury community. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Joe Peterson.
Good evening, my fellow WestCon students, faculty, and Danbarians. I'd like to know how everyone's beautiful Taco Tuesday is doing today. You doing well?
Oh, amazing tacos.
Amazing tacos?
Yeah.
We would have provided tacos for you all, but we were concerned about some allergic reactions, so we decided it's safer just to mention it. Hope you all enjoy it and maybe get some tacos afterwards. But for right now, you know, safety reasons, we decided not to bring them for you guys, okay?
I'm bigger.
So if I'm elected as your mayor, my first order of business would be address the current health precautions here at Western Connecticut State University. As we all know, we just dealt with the apocalypse and the plague. So I will make a duty to ensure that this kind of thing never happens again. Being a nurse at the Danbury Hospital right around the corner, I work firsthand to figure out the best ways to keep the buildings and the dorms safe, not only for you guys, but as well for the commuters and all those who don't live on campus. I can also make sure to improve the health services provided for both campuses and make sure that whatever company is providing the nutrition for our great school that is up to date on the current health trends and outbreaks for all those foods that are being served to us. This way it never happens again and we don't have to deal with another plague. The water main break, that apocalyptic thing, that can just happen randomly, but as your mayor, I will do everything in my power to make sure that all the pipes are up to date so that kind of thing doesn't happen every couple months. Another thing I would like to do as your mayor is make sure that our school system budgets are never taken for granted. I believe that education can never be taken lightly, especially when it comes to the youth of our kids. As we know, Danbury is a very diverse town and city in the state of Connecticut. Danbury High School has, I believe, over 5,000 languages being spoken at any given time. So having an education that helps them learn not only just one language, but two or three is great for them, whether they pursue college, trade school, the military like myself, or anything else, starting a business like another candidate of ours did. Just make sure that they have that education, that background to get the job done. With that, I'd like to segue into my next order of business, and that is promoting the city of Danbury. As your mayor, I would promote it as a safe, fun, easy town to live in. As many of you know, that the Danbury, like I said before, is very diverse, which is a great investment not only for your local businesses, but as well for everyday peoples and their family. Being so diverse, all the kids will be able to understand and appreciate where others come from and better understand different cultures growing up, which will only help them further in their life, whether that be through school, work, etc. The city of Danbury is a great place to live, not only because it's great place to embrace multiple cultures, but the location is great too. Located in the southwest portion of Connecticut, Danbury is located about 1 to 2 hours outside of New York City. As we all know, it's a great place to visit, one of the best cities in the world, which makes having a day trip to the city that much easier. Not to mention that Danbury is one of the most historic places in the country, being founded in 1685 and being one of the nation's biggest hatting empires. This great city is rich with history at every turn. Another reason why this great city is a great place to live is because of how safe it is. As it was mentioned before, Danbury has a low crime rate and has a great police force that is working to keep the streets safe, not only for you, but for the community. The police help catch the bad guys so that you can sleep soundly at night and not worry about break-ins, gang violence, drugs, or other reasons that keep you up at night. So as your mayor, I will make sure that the safety of greater Danbury area will never be compromised because all we want in life is to walk outside and be safe. Have a good life. So please join me in taking the Peterson Pledge and make Danbury a better place to live. Thank you.
Are there any questions for Mr. Peterson?
Two questions.
Yes, sir.
Will you say that it's really important to spend quality time with parents and their children?
Right.
How will you manage that if you are a single parent.
I will make sure I set time between my busy schedule. Now that the semester is ending, I'll have more time because I won't have to focus on school as much. But being a registered nurse and being a politician, I'll set time aside to talk to those families that have questions for me or have questions about what I will be doing as mayor.
You're not answering my question. It's like, how will you spend time with your daughter?
With my daughter?
Yes.
Like I said.
If you're elected for mayor, I'm sorry.
Right. Like I said, I will portion my time correctly. So, you know, during the day, if I have business to take care of, I will take care of it. But my daughter is my number one priority. Being a single dad, if she needs me, I'll be there for her any day of the week, any time of the week. So yeah. Yes, sir.
Going back to the question he said, you said you was finishing up school.
Yes, sir.
So you're not done with college?
Not at the moment, no. I'm working
and
towards
you
my
ran for mayor?
Bachelor's to get a medical degree.
So what is your background for, like, political? You said you're a nurse. What is your background in the field? Or, you know?
My political background is very little.
Okay.
Like I said, I did serve in the military, so I know how the defense and all that works out. Being a nurse, I know how the healthcare industry works. Being very involved in the school, I know how the education and that budget works. So combining all of that with this great team of mine, we can get the job done for you. Yes, ma'am.
I saw that you talked about Westcon losing water and not having clean water.
Correct.
But you didn't talk about the families around this area that had lost water or the restaurants and people that other people that were impacted.
Right.
Is there a reason you didn't mention the other people
well,
and only the college
I didn't
students?
Mention them specifically only because, like I did say, I talked about updating all the pipes, which will affect all those other families and businesses and whatnot. So, you know, that goes inside with fixing the water pipes, okay? Yes, ma'am.
What are you going to school for?
Like they said before, I'm going to school to become a nurse so I can
further
my education. Well, I gotta have that nursing degree so I can go to medical school.
So how are you gonna do that
get,
and be a mayor?
Brain surgeon.
But
sorry?
You're already a nurse at Danbury Hospital.
Right.
You said brain surgeon if you didn't, you guys didn't hear.
Do you
want to
be a mayor or a
brain
surgeon?
Or a father.
Guys, I'm able to do both. Not at the same time, because I don't think anyone would be able to do that. But if I have that background of being a brain surgeon, I can start my career off as a brain surgeon and then switch to being a politician. Or right now, because I'm campaigning, I can put that on the back burner. And when I'm done serving this great community, go back to the medical field.
You're just
going
to put us on the back burner and go to school?
That for you.
What?
You'd be willing to do that for the community.
Absolutely. And your question was?
You're going to put us on the back burner when it's time to go back to school in the fall?
No, because I'm still going to take online classes.
Wait, I am. I usually wait to the end to ask my one question, same question to ask every other
candidate.
As many
questions as you like, sir.
But I just have to ask this based on the questions I've heard. So you're a single parent.
Yes, sir.
Who's going to school to be a nurse.
Yep.
He's already a nurse.
He's a registered
nurse. I'm so confused. You are registered. You're a nurse.
He said he's a nurse.
I'm going to school to become a brain surgeon.
You're going to school, so you're a nurse, which are long hours, stressful job. You're going to be a brain surgeon.
Yep.
And you also want to be married. Why do you want to do all of these things, especially when you have a daughter and you're a single parent?
Do you have a different agenda?
To better the community, so my
please let him answer my question before you go off on some tangent. Thank you, sir.
What was your question again? I'm sorry.
How can you do it all? I mean, there's only 24 hours in a day.
His military lifestyle has prepared him for multiple duties all at once. In the military, he served as a medic, and that's an extremely stressful job, and that requires a lot out of you. So Joe is the type of person that is able to do multiple things at the same time, and he was definitely respected by all of his admirals and commanders within the Army, and was known for his well time management. So I don't think being a brain surgeon and the mayor will be any issue for him.
Well, quick question. Wait, ma'am, I have a quick question, ma'am. May I have a follow-up?
Sure.
While he was serving in the military, was his daughter there with him?
No, when he was serving.
So while he's serving for mayor,
no,
he will have his daughter here.
No,
so don't you think that's an extra factor
to
consider?
Okay,
ma'am, you're cutting me off. You're cutting me off.
Fake
news, okay?
Sorry,
I'm just gonna stop and let other people ask.
What was your MOS in the military?
A
medic. He was a medic.
Did there's the official title of your MOS.
A medic. I was a staff sergeant.
That's not your. That's not your. That's your rank. Your official MOS will be like 91 Bravo, 42 Kilo. What is? If you're a medic, you should know this.
I do not feel comfortable answering that question because you guys are all the way back to my military background.
Impersonating an army person.
Not a
Why does your campaign team know more about your own life than you?
Well, we're very close campaign group, so.
But you don't even know where I was, connection they then. Did.
Well, she took over. Hey,
and he believes in women's rights. I don't think you should be hostile towards him because he let his campaign team, and perhaps this is his manager on the team, I don't know, step in and provide information. I mean, we're a large group of people, folks. Let's be fair. He's one candidate. So let's be respectful in the questions we pose.
One serious question. How old is your daughter?
She's 7.
And how old are you?
30.
The time I didn't match
you
anything.
Were you married when you had your baby?
Nothing matches.
Yeah, we got married at 18. I enlisted in the Army at 20.
So how long were you in the Army?
I was in the Army for 4 years. Because once I was enlisted, we found out that my wife was not only pregnant, but she had brain cancer. So I did one tour, and I came back to help out at home.
Is that why you want to be a brain surgeon?
Yes, ma'am.
Cool. One problem.
All right, I have one question, a question to ask everybody else. And we'll end with this question just so, because I believe we have one other candidate at this forum who would like to speak. What was your candidate profile that I read in the newspaper, the Danbury News Times, what was the issue that was a challenge for you?
My challenge
yes.
for me is that I am a strong advocate in establishing an official language for the community. As well as having
official language for what community?
Danbury community, the nation. I believe that there's one language that should be outspoken across. You can speak more than one, but we should.
Oh, you mean like speak English only?
Not only. It should be the official language that everyone should know how to speak and communicate with.
So in Danbury, you do know that there's a sizable Latino, also referred to as Hispanic population.
I'm saying
you
should
make them
know how to communicate through it. They should know how to speak English. You can speak more than one. But, the official language should be English that everyone understands. Any other questions?
No, I didn't.